All right, guys, I've decided to take on the Meredith Duxbury Foundation Challenge. She's been doing it for years now. I've never attempted it. Number one, I don't want to waste my foundation. Number two, my skin's very dry and more mature, so it would not work for me for a daily. But she's now like putting out the challenge, so I feel like I want to try it. So I've already prepped my skin really super hydrated. I even put aloe vera gel on there to set everything in and hold in the moisture. But I feel like I'm going to need some kind of a primer for this. So I'm going to use the NYX Plump It Right Back around the outside of my face. And then I'm going to use the She Glam. This is that little birthday primer that actually helps with pores. So I'm just going to put that where I definitely have open pores in the center of my face, because you're probably going to see everything with this foundation. I have no idea. Like I said, I haven't tried it. So let's see how this works. So let's start this. Okay, I'm going to roll up my sleeves. And I have many foundations, but I feel like I'm going to use these two right here. The Catrice HD Liquid Coverage. I know she's used this in a couple of hers. But then I also have the NARS Light Reflecting Foundation. I don't want to use the heavier ones. If I'm already going to be using 10 pumps, I don't need to use a very heavy foundation. So here we go. Oh my God. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then this one I'm going to put on. She drips it on, but I don't want to drip it on my clothes. So I'm just going to drip a couple in here. I'm going to do a couple little squirts just to give it a different texture. It's a little bit more, even a little bit more wetter than the other one. I'm going to take my spatula from my eyebrow brush and just blend it in there. Eek. And we're going to go ahead and put it on. Another reason I chose these ones is because they're pretty much the most to my color. And I'm going to use all of it. I don't want to waste any of this. I'm like scraping it off with a little spatula. So here we go, guys. Okay. And then we all know we are going to use our hands. And just rub it in. Look, if you're washing your face with your foundation. Oh, God. Okay, my brows are like wiped out, so that's a huge thing right there. Wow, you guys, I don't really hate it. Okay, look at my hands. Gross. I'm gonna go wash my hands really quick. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and go with a sponge and just kind of get this all like kind of set in there. It's not really, it's already covered, so I'm just basically taking any way of the streaks away from my fingers. And then going back, if you don't know who Meredith Duxbury is, I'm not going to say you're living under a rock, but you're definitely not on TikTok, because she's one of the most famous TikTokers, so that's who I'm doing right now. So for concealer, I do use two different concealers. I'm going to go with Juvia's Place today. I'm going to go more of one of my skin tone first, and then I'm going to do a lighter one right in the center just to give it a little bit more of like a lightened look. Just like that. Now I'm going to take my sponge and we're going to blend it out. As she says, blend, blend, blend. Now that it's all blended out, my concealer, we're going to go ahead and definitely need contour, because you're literally look like a blank slate right now. I'm going to use my darkest contour stick, which is from Revolution, and this one is the F14. I don't use this on a daily basis at all because it's really dark. I just use a little bit, but I definitely need to bring back those contours of my face, so I'm going to use this one. Now we're just going to blend it out. I'm gonna go back with my beauty sponge and just kind of make sure it's all blended in. For those of you that follow me, you know that I always do my brows first, and this is why. Look at, I have no brows, but obviously with this technique, I could not go all over my face with my hands and get into my brows. So I literally looked so weird without brows. Now I want a pretty strong cream blush. So I'm gonna go with the Made by Mitchell in Sweet Cheeks and just get this on my cheeks. And then I'll even put some on my nose and on my forehead and a little bit on my chin. And we'll blend that all out as well. definitely need to set this with powder. For under my eyes, I always use a little light translucent powder first. So I'm gonna do the Charlotte Tilbury powder, and I'm gonna go first with the translucent powder just with a little brush. And then I'm gonna go ahead and go with the Huda Beauty in the Cherry Blossom Cake. And that one, I'm just gonna literally set that underneath there with lots of powder while I do my eyes and the rest of my makeup. So we're just gonna go ahead and do this. This is just for under my eyes. So that's just for under my eyes, that real pinky one. For the rest of the face underneath, I'm gonna use the Beauty Bakery powder in Oat Translucent. It's, you can see it's more yellow. And I'll also do that around the nose. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do the rest of my makeup and I'll be back. Okay guys, so I'm back with the rest of my makeup and I'm gonna say I don't hate it. I literally am shocked that it doesn't feel as heavy. It doesn't look as heavy as I thought it would. However, this is definitely nothing I would do every day. Even though my skin looks so like flawless, I can't do this every day. First of all, it's expensive to buy that much foundation if you're using 10 pumps a day. Second of all, it's messy. Third of all, it was hard for me to get into my brows. I don't have brows, so I use a lot of products. So I usually do my brows first thing, and I do my eyes. I usually put tape on the side of my eyes if I'm wearing like a winged look like this. And I would have to like clean up and put, I'd have to clean up all that foundation and reapply. So to me, it's just too many steps. So as much as I like it, I might do it if I'm wanting my skin to look super flawless, but yeah, it's definitely not something for me every day. Meredith can pull it off. She's 25 years younger than me, so you know, her skin can handle this much makeup. But anyways, I'm super excited that I did it and I tried it and I do like it. And yeah, if you guys haven't tried it, give it a try.